一列长长的铁道列车如梦似幻地穿越泰国最大水库巴沙村拉溪水坝，画面看起来就像是日本动画电影《神隐少女》里出现的水上火车场景。泰国国铁编号921的漂浮火车4号，也就是今年营运季开始的头一天，吸引好几百名乘客大清早6点睡眼惺忪地赶到曼谷车站上车。三个半小时的车程，沿途荷花池、丛林、庙宇、稻田在眼前呼啸而过。中途抵达大城之后，还有小贩登车贩售棉花糖、打抛猪肉等在地小吃。抵达巴沙村拉溪水坝的高架桥会在这里停留20分钟，让乘客下车尽情的打卡自拍，
更让我觉得很壮观。对，就是我没有体验过，就是那种可以站在火车上，然后还可以什么对着火车来拍那个整个就是大坝的美景那种感觉，所以我觉得很震撼。
And during the cool season, which is the end of the rainy season, the water is at the very highest level. So when you cross the reservoir on both sides of the train, you will see water that gives the impression of a floating train. So it's quite unique, and it's quite exciting to actually have that experience because it's like going across the sea.
整年大部分的时间，火车行驶的高架桥底下都是牛群在吃草，但是十月到一月这段时间水位高涨，一望无际的水景看起来列车就好像是在水面上行驶一样。英国的旅游布洛克指出，这条水上火车路线目前只有泰语宣传物，还没有英文版，因此还没有太多外国游客知道，但独特的景致加上营运时间短，往往车票一开卖，本地的游客就抢破头了。
I think in Europe and America and certainly Japan, there is a rail culture and people want to travel by train as part of the holiday. But the problem is in Thailand, all the trips like this one today is only publicized in the Thai language. There's nothing in English at all. And the same with the steam excursion that goes 6 times a year, there's nothing in English. So it's kind of a missed opportunity.
华富里水上火车的车厢分为无空调车厢、有空调车厢以及 VIP 沙发座车厢。曼谷的冬季高温也会来到摄氏30度，旅游达人建议为了舒适起见，最好是购买空调车厢的座位，避免热过头。公视新闻王宏宇编译。